Hello dear friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Mukesh English. In this video, we will go through an inspiring story of a girl titled My Teacher by Helen Keller. This is a story of this girl's meeting with the teacher who would change her life. It's a beautiful story of how a little 7-year-old girl grew determined to accept herself and navigate her life later. Helen Keller was an American author, political activist, and lecturer. She was the first deaf-blind person to earn a Bachelor of Arts degree. She was born in Alabama on 27 June 1880. Her father, Arthur H. Keller, he was the editor for the North Alabamian, and he had fought during the American Civil War. In 1882, she was 19 months old and she was stricken by an illness that left her blind and deaf. In 1886, according to the advice of an ENT specialist, her parents contacted Alexander Graham Bell, who was working with deaf children at that time. Bell advised them to contact Parkinson's Institute for the Blind. The director of the institute asked former student Anne Sullivan to become Helen Keller's instructor. That was the beginning of a 49-year-old relationship with a teacher. Anne Sullivan came to her house on 3rd March 1887 and helped her make tremendous progress with her ability to communicate. The present excerpt, My Teacher, is taken from Helen Keller's autobiography, The Story of My Life. It's an inspiring story of a person who discovered the world through her fingertips with the help of a great and dedicated teacher. This remarkable story of teacher Anne Sullivan and her student Helen Keller has been told throughout generations. One cannot mention one name without thinking of the other, since the two lived and worked together for decades, until Sullivan's death in 1936. Helen Keller recalls the afternoon of the 3rd March 1887 as the most important day of her whole life. It was the afternoon of this eventful day that her teacher, Anne Mansfield Sullivan, arrived. This was 3 months before she turned 7 years. Before her education, Helen was filled with anger and bitterness. She compared herself with a ship stuck in a dense fog, surrounded with white darkness and without any compass or guide. Being blind and deaf, she took a toll on her, and she desperately needed someone to guide her out of her misery. Just then, Anne Sullivan arrived as a savior. The morning after Anne Sullivan arrived, she gave Helen a doll sent by the blind children at Parkinson's Institution. Until later, Helen was unaware that Laura had dressed it. While Helen played with the doll, Miss Sullivan slowly spelled the word doll, D-O-L-L, onto her hand. An interested Helen imitated the spelling game, and on succeeding, she was filled with the joy and pride. Until then, Helen was oblivious to the existence of spellings and words. She slowly learned to spell many words and finally unraveled the fact that everything had a name. Helen was new to the spelling, and learning names and words would often get muddled, and she failed to distinguish between two different objects. She shares an example where she mistook water and mug to be the same. Once, when her teacher tried to make Helen understand this, her impatience got the best of her. She threw her doll on the floor, resulting in it breaking. She felt no sorrow or regret for her passionate outburst. Following this incident, Anne Sullivan took Helen to the well house. Someone was drawing water, Anne Sullivan placed Helen's hand under the spout. As one hand felt the cool stream, Anne Sullivan spelled the word water, W-A-T-E-R, on the other hand. It was at this moment that Helen suddenly felt like she found a missing piece in a puzzle. She at last understood that water meant the wonderful, cool something that was flowing over her hand. This discovery awakened Helen's soul. It gave her light and hope that she had always yearned for and set her free. She left the well house with a new determination and eagerness to learn. Everything had a name, and each name gave birth to a new thought. When she returned home, every object that she touched seemed to come alive. This was a result of her renewed perception. When she remembered the doll she had broken, she picked up the pieces and tried to put them together, but her eyes turned teary. She realized her mistake, and for the first time, she felt repentance and sorrow. Helen learned many new words that day. Among them were mother, father, sister, and teacher. She felt like she had attained some magical powers. That day, she was the happiest child, and as she lay in her crib for the first time in forever, she longed for a new day to come. The story of Helen Keller is immensely inspiring. It teaches one to be patient and brave. Regardless of her condition, Helen Keller never gave up. Instead, she fiercely stood up and learned to live life to the fullest. We often get disheartened at the smallest inconvenience. This story teaches us to adapt and improvise. Helen was not born this way, but a childhood illness turned her blind and deaf. Rather than wasting her time in darkness, she gained knowledge and decided to advocate it. Anne Sullivan also excelled in her role as a guide and teacher. She understood that Helen required special assistance, and she was patient with her throughout their entire journey. One must attempt to always spread knowledge and positivity, because they are the things that do not diminish even after sharing. Dear friends, thank you so much for watching this video. You can reach me at mukeshenglish@gmail.com. Please do subscribe the channel, click on the like button for more videos on literature, workbook, pronunciation, grammar, communication skills, presentation skills, interview skills. Stay in tune with Mukesh English. Thank you once again.